I think people would be surprised to know that I'm still around, and I guess I'm even more surprised than they are.
Manny, they tell me I've been given 90 seconds to talk about you. That's not even a second for every year of your age.
This is a man who is now well into his 90s and has not given up one footstep along the way.
He's not one of these grandparents who thinks ice cream costs 25 cents. He knows. He knows what the world is like out there.
Manny, great party man. Loves to dance, loves music, loves. He really is a great party man.
He's a vital, vigorous, engaged person. And he's not a young man. But you wouldn't know it when you read what he does, and you wouldn't know it when you meet him.
Fairy tales can come true, it can happen to you. If you're young at heart. For it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind. If you're young at heart.
We appreciate your tenacity and the way in which you fearlessly go after what you believe in. So amazed by your devotion to family and to the community at large, and of course the way you love all of us so much.
We also appreciate your incredible generosity, your willingness and openness to learning new things. We appreciate the way that you support the growth and development of so many people around the world, including your grandchildren and great-grandchildren.
We all know Manny for many things, but primarily as an advocate for and protector of our most precious resource, our children. And as for this, amongst other things, that we honor him here today. He has served our community, he has served our country, he has served families. He was a community organizer before that word became popular jargon. And so here we are today, Manny. It's our pleasure and privilege to be honoring you here at the Jewish Community Foundation.
You're the story of my life. And every word is true. Each chapter sings your name. Each page begins with you.
One of the interesting things about Manny telling the story was that he believed it shouldn't just be his story. He believed his story connected with the whole story of the Jewish community in Montreal and how it evolved. And certainly when he started here, it was just a very young immigrant community. So he thought tracking his life would be a way of sort of telling the story of the community. His personal story was not, you know, victory to victory. It was very much overcoming some difficulties, and he had difficulties learning disabilities, plus he was sort of in the shadow of his older brother, who was the famous judge. So he was very aware of all that. He wanted to show other people, kids especially, you know, that they could overcome anything if they put their mind to it.
My mother was Orthodox. My father was a socialist, and he used to come, my mother told me, to the house on Saturday morning with his talus bag. And after spending a little time with her, he would then go out into the woods to find his friends who were socialists, and they had a socialist meeting. My sister was a communist and a person who had no use for religion or Judaism, but nevertheless became a strong Zionist. The person who I think had the greatest influence in our family was my eldest brother, Harry, who became the first Jewish judge in the Superior Court. And so while on the one hand, it was very difficult for us to attempt to match him, nevertheless, it gave us a standard to follow. My brother gave me a membership in the YMHA, and that brought me together with opportunities because I became a club leader, and then I became the director of youth activities, and then I was the educational director there. It was pretty natural for me to want to go into social work. I'm always amused and enjoy the thought that Boris Levine was one of my kids at the Y, as was Rabbi Shushad.
Amongst other things, he taught us what it meant to be communal leaders, what it meant to be communally involved. And some of us took that seriously. In my own case, it's a bit of history.
It had to be.
I came from a very modest family. Rachie Levitt came from a very distinguished family in Montreal, and she was a social worker. And I think the thing that influenced me a lot, beyond the fact that I enjoyed Rachie as a person, is the fact that her family was prominent and had status. I came from a very modest, humble family, and I think that must have influenced me because I was ambitious. I'd say the most important thing that happened to us was giving birth to Mark, our son. And Mark, while he was an only child, because we had lost two or three in miscarriages, nevertheless, he's made up for those we've lost and those that might have come after him. After a very long and happy life with Rachel, we lived together for nearly 50 years. I found it almost impossible to live alone without her.
Manny went about finding a wife in as orderly and determined a fashion as he does everything else. Lyne and I used to pore over names sort of thing to see who could we recommend that Manny take out. And Sarah pops up and says, "Mom, why don't you introduce Manny to Ruth Heller?" And Lyne and I looked at each other and we thought, you know what? That's a very good idea. So we arranged for them to meet. And it was click, click,